Welcome to the Great Exodus series. God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go. The path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael and I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is Be a Living Sacrifice. But before we go there, we are going to our mission to Cambodia. To start, the tickets are booked and we are flying on the 13th of August. Please help us. Oh, provide us with your blessings so that we can reach as many people as possible there. We need transport. We need more Bibles. We need conference places. We need teaching places. We want to bring the people together for prayer meetings. We want to bring the people together for teachings and understandings, so that they come out of their false beliefs, false gods and idols, that they will see the light. This mission is very important because we want to establish societies of the rose in that country, so that then it grows greater and greater and that the flame of the Father will be kindled at that place. Please watch our video about our mission to Cambodia. It will be also linked in the first pinned comment. And also there I will link the possibilities to make donations. So please help us on our mission to Cambodia. Thank you. And now let us return to the topic that we have at hand. Be a living sacrifice. It is written in Romans 12:1. Paul said there that we should become a living sacrifice. And this is not a living sacrifice, is not slaughtering of a lamb. It is a daily sacrifice of love. The love that we have seen through Jesus, of the Father, this we should spread every day. This is what we do in the societies of the Rose, what we do on our walk towards Mount Zion. We do a daily sacrifice. We come together every day and we do righteous deeds of the saints every day. And this is being a living sacrifice. That's the reason why people call us also the daily sacrificer, because we do it every day. And people will recognize you and your assembly of love and righteousness, your society of the rose, for that. They will say, look, every day they go out and do something good. Every day they help the needy. Every day they lift up the nameless and faceless. Every day they take care of the Lazarus at their gates. Then you say, yes, because we do a daily sacrifice in the name of the Father. And this is exactly what Paul was talking about in Romans 12:1. And he asks you to be a daily sacrifice, because if he explained it in the following verses, he talks about the righteous deeds, the good deeds, and the love that you should spread, so that everybody will recognize you as a true son and daughter of the Most High, that everybody will know you belong to the people who walk the path. And this is what you should do. People should say, look, these people are different. They do a daily sacrifice of love every day. Why are they doing that? Then others will say, because they walk that path. What path? Yeah, you can go and listen. They will tell you what path. A path to Mount Zion, to the holy mountain, where they will meet the Father, the only living God, and his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and King of the Millennium. And you can be part of this, and walk with us. But you should not sit and wait. You should become a daily sacrificer. You should do a daily sacrifice of love. Can you do that alone? Yes and no. You should do that together, in love, unity, and support, in a community of righteous people. Because then you can have much more power and much more influence. Do you have to do it somewhere or travel for it? No. You can do it in your neighborhood. You can start right now. You can call the people together for your Society of the Rose, your Assembly of Love and Righteousness, and you can start today. But if you start, do not forget, it is a commitment to our Father in Heaven. That means you cannot start today and tomorrow you forget about it. You do it and then you stick to it. And on the way, this is your path, your new path, and on the way to Mount Zion, we will bring as many people as possible to righteousness, to holiness, to what the Father wants. What does the Father want? That you become a true son and daughter of Him. Why? Because He has set you that example through Jesus Christ as a true son. And is it not written that only through Him you will reach the Father? Only through true sonship, or even a daughter, because sonship applies to men and women. Only through true sonship you will reach the Father. And only as a true son or daughter you will be a co-heir with Jesus Christ. So become a living sacrifice. We have everything ready for you. The whole structure is set up. You only have to come in agreement. And you only have to start. Everything, all the resources, everything is given to you through our website, www.grace.com. Register there, become a member, and then you have access to all the resources. You can ask me any of your questions, how to start, how to do everything under our ministry email, www.grace55@gmail.com. And you can listen to all of our videos. There are so many videos about that, about Triple Grace, about the Societies of the Rose, about daily sacrifice. We have a whole video about daily sacrifice. Just watch it, get your understanding, and walk with us that path and bring in the great harvest. Spread the word. Use your social media account to spread our videos. Bring them to our website. Let them become members. Let them join us together in huge groups through the whole continents and in every country, every town if possible. Let them see the light through the Societies of the Rose. Let them see the example that the Father wants to set forth into the dark world, because the Antichrist will come to rule it. Right now, the seals are ready to be opened. And then you will stand against the Antichrist. And how do you do that? By coming out of the world into the Assemblies of Love and Righteousness, Societies of the Rose, doing a daily sacrifice. And then the Antichrist will fume, because he will hate you, because he will show forth the love of the Father every day. But he will not be able to touch you, because he will be under the wings of protection of Yahweh and of Jesus Christ. And mighty angels will surround you. And there will be nothing that he can do to you. He will not even see you. He will not find you. But if you remain in the world, he will easily pick you out. So walk with us in the great exodus towards Mount Zion. Look at all the resources we offer at our website. If you have any question, everything will be answered there, because you can watch the videos, you can get all the understanding. Everything is written in the book of Revelation. Everything is written in the Holy Scripture. Look what Daniel said. Daniel said, and how long will it take until the daily sacrifice will be taken away? And this daily sacrifice, that's you. That is not the slaughtering of the lamb, as some funny teachers are proclaiming. No, this is you. Because you will be taken away in the rapture at Mount Zion. And you will be the daily sacrifice. From Romans 12:1, from what Paul said. You will be a daily sacrifice. And this daily sacrifice will be taken into the rapture at Mount Zion. And you will be part of it if you join us. Everything is clearly stated in the Holy Scripture. It's clearly stated that there will be a Mount Zion when Jesus comes down for the wrath of the Lamb at the sixth seal. The people will hide in the caves because of his power and glory. That's the time when he comes down on Mount Zion. That's the time of the rapture of the remnant, or the rapture of the church. Now what we have in the short period now, and then maybe next few weeks, will be the escape of the bride. But that's not the rapture. That's an escape, a vanishing of the bride. But the rapture of the church will take place at the sixth seal. at Mount Zion. And there also the 144,000 will be sealed to continue their work in the trumpet period that will follow. There is so much understanding that people do not have. Many people do not understand about the timeline of the Exodus, the timeline of the Revelation. They don't understand. They all think everything must be 7 years, 7 years, 7 years. How do you fit all the events in 7 years? It's impossible, because it's wrong. The only right timeline is that we actually had a total of 21 years. But now 7 years are finished. The easy years were finished. Now we go into the seal period, what is another 7 years. And then we go into the trumpet and bowl period, what is in the last 7 years. So now when we start the seal period, then we have now 14 years until the coming of our Lord and Savior and King of the Millennium. What will happen around 31, 32, 33? Exactly 2,000 years after his crucifixion. So that everything what is written will be fulfilled. After 2 days, after 2,000 years, I will revive you and bring you into the millennium. All what is written will be fulfilled. All prophecies will be fulfilled. God is Almighty. Our God is a living God. Yahweh. Anybody else who tells you different things, they have no idea what they're talking about. They're just guessing. It must fit with scripture. It must fit with everything. So there is no way that it can be going beyond 2033. And there's also no way that the 7 year period can start right now, because then we will end up 2026. 2,000 years ago, in the year 26 AD, there was nothing important. So this cannot be the time period. You have to understand. Was it not 6,000 years? 6 days of creation, then 1 day of rest? So, 6,000 years and 1,000 for millennium. Now, then you look. 2,000, then 2,000 years for the Israelites, for the Jews, or the Israelites at this time, and then Jesus came. And then 2,000 years from Jesus' crucifixion until the time when the 1,000 years of millennium will start. Easy and clear. No discussion about it. Nothing. Everything else, people say this cannot be true, then they're on the wrong path. But you should walk the right path, the path to Mount Zion. Especially if you do not understand what happened, then please read the book of Revelation, the sixth seal. Read what is there. Is in the sixth seal not Jesus coming down? Are the people not hiding from the wrath of the Lamb? Right? He is not yet the Lion of Judah, because the Lion of Judah is coming at the end. When he steps down on the Mount of Olives, the sixth seal, he's not stepping down on the Mount of Olives. He comes down on the Mount of Zion. And everybody will see him. It is clearly written in the sixth seal. And this is the place where we want to be at that time. As a multitude clothed in white. The base of Mount Zion. When our Lord and Savior is coming to that mountain. And also his Father, his Throne of Glory, will be on top of that mountain. And we will have access to the holy place. I'm urging you to understand this and to walk with me. This is your path towards your rapture. Do not get deceived by other people who tell you can just sit and wait. Then the Antichrist will take you out. Your only way of survival is to come out of the world and to walk that path. And to become a living sacrifice of the Father. To bring forth a daily sacrifice of love. The righteous deeds of the saints. Read the Bible. The white clothes that you need to enter heaven. To enter your eternal life. Is what it is written in the Bible. It is the righteous deeds of the saints. And this is what you will do every day, the righteous deeds of the saints. then you qualify. That is exactly what the multitude clothed in white have done. They have qualified because they made their dirty garment white in the blood of the lamb. Now, the blood of the lamb. What is a bloody lamb? A sacrifice. Since now Jesus has fulfilled the lamb sacrifice, and you become a living sacrifice. Don't you understand what Romans 12:1 tells you? You have to be a living sacrifice, and that needs to do righteous deeds and not to sit and say, I'm saved for all, forever, and I don't have to do anything. No. Jesus is calling you forth onto that path. You will be called the daily sacrificer, and you will be also called the follower of the path. And then when people say, what path? The path to Mount Zion, our eternal life. And there we will receive the glory of the Father. I hope you have understood what is about be a living sacrifice. And that is written all over the Bible. And that is a whole concept that you will make yourself ready to go into the rapture. And on the way, you will gather as many people as possible to righteousness and into the harvest and into the barn of the Father. You will enter the dark territory of the enemy to snatch the pearls that are there under his control from his dragon lair and bring it to the feet of the Father. And that's exactly what we are doing now next month in our mission to Cambodia. And that's also the reason why I ask you to help us. I know you cannot go with us there. But you can support us, you can sponsor us, you can provide us with the funds so that we can reach as many people as possible. God will bless you for your donations. So please help us. Come for us today. The link for the donations are in the first pinned comment. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that my words are not falling onto deaf ears, but that you understand, that you re-listen to the messages, that you listen to all what we have brought forth on our YouTube channel. And if you have questions, just come to me. I'm here for you. If you have problems, come to me. I am here for you. Just use our ministry email, triplegrace55@gmail.com. If you do not understand something, come to me. I am here for you. Thank you. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that we all walk together that path to Mount Zion. Tomorrow we have a new topic in our Great Exodus series. Please help us in our mission to Cambodia. Subscribe, share the videos with everybody, watch all our series that we have at YouTube, and please become a member of our website www.grace.com. May God bless you and your family abundantly. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And I wish you a blessed day. Maranatha.